Hi all, I've admitted there are about 20 to 30 participants here. I want all of you to mute yourself and welcome to the DIY STEAM workshop once again. Today is June 9th and we have the fifth workshop up the sleeve, and we have Ms. Aprupa Gupta here, who is going to be doing the DIY activities, and the topic being the power of game, and that's what it is. She has 17 years experience in the field of education, and she's a curriculum head and a primary head of the Green School Bangalore. And this is done under TGSB, the Green School Bangalore. Ms. Manju Chakravarti, the admin head and the middle school coordinator, has coordinated the entire DIY workshop with parents. So warm welcome to all the educators here and the teachers, educators, heads, as well as parents. So I'm sure about it that all the children are very excited because they do not know what is up, what is in store for them. And I'm sure about it, there's something very exciting because they told me that I'm also supposed to be involved in this. So a warm welcome to Ms. Aprupa Gupta and Ms. Priyanki Debroy, the teacher of TGSB, who is helping Aprupa Gupta here for this workshop. So let me introduce you to Aprupa Gupta. Aprupa Gupta is here. Can I see Aprupa Gupta and Priyanki Debroy?
Together.
Yeah, good evening, everyone.
Good evening, everyone.
Wow, that's awesome.
So here we are back again with our fifth workshop. And as ma'am said, it's the power of game. So Usha ma'am, and she has always believed that play plays an important role in a child's development. In her sessions, she's always told gamification should be a part and parcel of the way you teach a child, because that's where they connect the best. So then Priyanki ma'am and I thought that why not dedicate this evening and explore some games, and let us give you some superpowers while you play that game with us. So are we ready to play those games? Yes?
Are you ready? Just put up your thumbs up like this.
Very good. Great.
And we all see all the videos on here. Don't unmute yourself. Just put your videos on and just do it like this. Aprupa will know you have to go.
Yes. And I would want all of y'all to be a part of this. Enjoy your for this next 1 hour.
So can anybody tell me why this saying is very famous? Ma'am, even you can try, give it a try. Do you really think this holds some value in real life? Without any play, will it really make us very dull?
What she's saying is all work and no play makes a dull boy. That's what she's saying. So do you all agree? You can unmute and talk.
Actually, we have, you know, reframed it, ma'am. We didn't want to put a jack and a jill. Said one becomes lazy, and when we meant lazy, we meant in all respect. So that's what the saying goes, and that's what Priyanki ma'am is asking. Do you all think that whatever is there in that saying, you all thoroughly believe in it, or you know, you all have some light to throw?
I think we should go ahead, ma'am.
Ma'am, you can take a try. Maybe Manju ma'am can take a try.
What is it regarding?
Ma'am, the saying we are asking, the saying that it goes, all work and no play makes one lazy. When we mean lazy, we mean in all respect. Lazy doesn't mean physically. Yes.
Mentally also. It makes a person lazy.
Absolutely. So therefore, today's session is going to not only look at your physical development, but your overall holistic part. Because if you're not well coordinated in your brain is not undergoing those critical thinking, strategic thinking, and is not doing the problem solving and logical reasoning, the cognitive part that we call, then there is no use playing those games. So Priyanki ma'am, I think from your last feedbacks, we have realized that, you know, there are very little things that we do for toddlers.
Yes.
Right? There are parents, ma'am, who have come back to us and told,
you always
show things which are very innovative for the K1s or the K2s, yes, and the higher grades. What about our toddlers? What do we do with them? So we put a thought together today, and we have come up with some games for toddlers. And if there are any toddlers or who have siblings who are toddlers, here is what they play. We are going to start with that today.
Okay, so if you can see, I'm showing you a picture. So this is kind of fun game, which is not only a game, but also a type of workout for the younger ones. So ma'am will just give it a brief, like what it is all about. Maybe she will also give a demo of the game. So let's see. So ma'am will just, yeah, ma'am will just translate into a toddler now.
Okay. I like that, Priyanki ma'am, putting me in a tight spot. So I have to prove my flexibility, ma'am. And, you know, getting flexible as you grow older is another aspect which, you know, our parents have to look into if they have to really do something with their younger ones. Just not telling them, but we have to do it along with them. Till you don't do something with those young ones, those toddlers who are full of energy, they are not going to do anything with you. So the game is very interesting. I will give you a demo. You all can also do. I mean, even the other ones can try. This game is for all ages, all across, and can be improvised as per age group. Why we are talking about toddlers? Because it's their gross motor skills. So here we are looking at, you know, the coordination of the leg and those soft toys that you saw over there. So the child needs to lie on the back straight with the soft toy between the two legs and try to hold it. Put the leg back. Keep the object small because then they can hold it together perfectly fine. As they move to pre-K, it could be a little bigger. And for the elder, a thing that moves, which could be a ball. So the ball doesn't stay stable. So the minute you go to hold it, it's going to like wobble around. So you're going to coordinate yourself to...
I think your internet is not a little stable. It's freezing, your video.
So let us get going with the game.
Children just love such, you know, cute, cute things and soft, because it is looking at your sensorial things also. So as cute as this, and ma'am, are you going to focus?
Yes,
I'm
sure.
Going to do
so
it.
You have to mute.
Ma'am, wish me luck because I'm going to test my flexibility skills today, right now. Okay, we go on mute here and focus is on my
flexibility. Okay. Ma'am, it's a challenge for everybody. Yeah, okay. If you want to test. I don't know how far I'll be doing. So, okay, there I go. Lying down.
Yes. Lying on a back.
Yes. Just going to look at your back movement and your leg and holding it this way, keeping your hand. So, I'm not going to put this hand on my leg. Only if I require the support, I will do that. Maybe I will require it. Let's see. Putting the hands on the side and there I go. Now, that's the only flexibility I have. But the children are much more flexible and they can go much more behind and they can just throw it out over there. But I can't. So that's it. Now, if I put a ball, it's going to become very difficult. It's under the table.
Okay.
It's rolled there already. So let's try with this. But I can't see anything here. And maybe. Okay. Ma'am, I think I've got it. Okay. I've got the grip. I just
hope. Can all of you do it? Do you all want to do it along with ma'am?
Well, I think you did a good job.
Yes.
Yes. So, you could try this with your children. Something here.
You have to unmute yourself, Aprupa.
Sorry, I burned a lot of energy and calories over here. I think I'll do this every day, ma'am, because it is looking at, you know, taking care of all the extra calories that we have added sitting at home with less exercise. And the younger ones will have fun doing this because they are full of energies. They'll be jumping up and down and doing things. Okay, coming to exercise number two, or maybe the power of game two. Yes. Let's see, what do we have in store?
Well, there's a child who is doing it.
So Monica. Now, Monica. So these are the next lineup of activities. So maybe we can try one or two from them. Right, ma'am?
Yes.
So maybe we will take two from them.
Let's see how the time performance and the rest we can always explain. So I am going to look at doing the L fun with y'all. So I will not look at the explanation of that. But what I'm going to do right now, Priyanki ma'am, is going to explain about the frog on a pond, chameleon and the bean bag.
Okay,
that's what I'm going to explain.
Sure, ma'am. And the coordination also, we can just show them how to play.
Yes.
Yeah.
Unmute, please. Yeah. Unmute.
Chameleon and the bean bag. So what is the chameleon and the bean bag? Do we have to call for a garden lizard which changes its color? Or do we have to make one? None of them. Because here we are looking at resources that are readily available at home. All you need, you remember my jiggle with rice activity? So we're going to make bean bags out of them. Or you make bean bags out of rava. You can put them in papers and then staple it all across, or you put them in a cloth, or even in a, you know, those, what do you call them, ma'am? Those plastic, not plastic, actually, where you put those vegetables in to remain it secured. So those Ziploc bags, and put that in. Now, you could have them in various colors. So as I showed you last time, how the rice takes up all the colors, you can have different colors over there. So that is actually a chameleon. It will keep on changing the color because we are going to have some 4, 5, or even 10, and we're going to number those bags. All they have to do is, once I, you know, it's like a memory game. All of us used to play this memory game. In our memory, we used to say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and somebody used to tell us stop. And then we used to do the name, place, animal thing. Improvisation here is, we do the number here, 1, 10, and somebody tells us stop. And whatever number comes, the child goes and picks up that number and starts throwing that number, juggling that many times. So suppose the number stops at 6, the child goes and identifies number 6 and throws it up and down 6 times. What have we achieved? We have achieved a value association. We have seen a connect of visual coordination of the number 6. And there is a eye to hand with the gross motor coordination here.
Priyanki, you mute yourself, Priyanki. It's echoing.
She's muted, ma'am. Yeah. Yes. So this is called the chameleon and the bean bag, which a toddler to a pre-K can be doing it as simple as it can be done at home. This can be extrapolated later to an odd and even number game. So the same numbers can become an odd and even. And you know, when you stop, you're going to say, pick up only odd number. So maybe first 5 odd numbers that come in a sequence in an ascending order, you can do that. So the way you want to do it is up to you. I leave the choice up to you. Don't have to be like looking at what toys I should buy to teach odd and even. Oh, you know, I have to buy a bean bag. Nothing. Just be at home, play these games, and it's fun. Expelling energy, using your logical thinking, critical skills, and they're all in place. Okay, ma'am. I think let's talk about the frog on a pond. The name is exciting, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Very exciting.
Yes, the name is exciting. Frog.
On.
Frog on a pond. On a pond. But frog can stay in water as well as on land. We all know that. This is for the elders, I mean the higher grades, to know. On is a preposition which can be taught. A is an article which can be taught. And of course, the noun and other things are also there. Now, what are you going to do over here? A very simple exercise. You can just take a paper and make a cylinder out of it. Now, you can use anything else also. If you have a chart paper, you have a construction paper, but any paper for that matter. So you make a cylinder or a cone, I mean, cylindrical shape on that. And now the strategy comes here. You can look up any YouTube and make the origami frog ready. I am not going to go into that. So you can make any kind of frog ready over here. And that frog is sitting ready to go on a pond, which is on this kind of a cylindrical thing. Now, what shape is going to balance on that cylinder is something the child needs to think. Is it a circle? Is it a square? Is it a triangle or any other shape? Now, they have to keep balancing that. And how many such can they balance? One, and the frog stays there. Two, the frog still stays there. Three, and the frog is still there. The twist in the story over here is the frog also has to go to the land. And how does the frog go to the land? So the origami frog, if you have noticed, if you press it from behind, it tends to jump. So when the frog jumps out, it should land down out of the thing without disturbing that entire thing that you have made. So that is a STEAM challenge for a child, integrated with numbers and a little bit of EVS. Now, to give some more masala into this, spice into this, you can cook up a beautiful story here with some audio in the background while the child is doing this activity with you or even without you. You need to explain. The child can keep exploring. Circle, okay, no. Triangle, okay, yes. Triangle circle, maybe. So different kind of explorations is what we are looking at for a child. Try it. It works. It really works well. Okay. Ma'am, can you just show one photograph of the same?
Yes, ma'am. So you can see that those cylinders, stack. You can stack on the cylinders to make the levels increase. One on one. This is what ma'am just now mentioned. This is the game all about. The cylinders, on top of that is the base. And if you can see the frog sitting on the cylinders there.
This is a pictorial depiction, but you can make the entire thing from the scratch. Now, the end of the all the things, now, this could be even a team activity during a birthday. I mean, obviously, we're not celebrating birthdays, but we can also do if you have a sibling or, you know, if you are playing with your children, father, mother, and the children are playing. And who can build how many towers? Maybe, you know, somebody can stack up three, somebody two, somebody one. Now, you see the data collection over here. So from big to small or small to big is something you can also show in a visual manner. So one game and so many things can be taught. The literacy, the EVS, the numeracy, of course, the STEAM challenge, and explore more and get back to us. What more you can add to it? We have added as much as we could. Okay, now come to an interesting game for a toddler, PK, even ma'am can play. You have to do this with us. So it's very easy. Get any paper that you have at home and one scissor and a pencil, pen or anything just to make a sketch. Please. Yes, we have already cut it, ma'am. So,
okay. Please get it fast, quick.
Yes.
So let's start.
Paper, scissor.
As soon as you have, just show it to us that you have got it.
And any kind of a pen, pencil. Fold the paper into half and half and half till you make a square out of it. Draw half. I'm giving you an easy method of drawing butterfly. You can still draw.
Apurva, you can see the other children also here. Switch on the video, you can watch.
I can only see doing it. So I'm only following.
Harvant is doing it.
Okay. So fold it. Yes, very good. Kanta is doing one more fold, Kanta. One more fold. Urvika, one more fold. I can see only her right now, ma'am. So I'm going with her. Others, please don't choose me. I can't see everybody over here. So when you have made a fold like this, I'll just give you an example. Now, where you have the middle portion, over here, you just draw half of the butterfly. Half. Just half. Don't draw the full butterfly. In this middle line over here, draw over here half the butterfly. And cut it, because when it opens up, it will give you several butterflies. Like this. I mean, this was a fast done thing. Okay. For toddlers, it's going to be very simple. They're going to just take and scribble on it with ball crayons. So their butterflies are going to be bigger than this. I've just taken a medium shaped butterfly. For toddlers, the butterflies are going to be even bigger, and give them to make it as colorful. So suppose you have got four butterflies coming out, please take different colors and color it as the way you please. Okay, I have a co-host doing this coloring activity.
So introducing our co-host. So he has transited now to the toddler phase or the pre-K or K1 level. So where he's coloring our butterflies.
You can be faster. We are not in our competition.
Here.
So it's just the essence of the game that we are doing.
So please color about four butterflies. That's more than enough. Ma'am, is anybody doing or only we are doing here? Please, this workshop is
Arvind for kids. Urvika is doing, Arvind is doing, and there's a boy doing it here.
I think every evening we end up doing, ma'am.
Yes, I can see this boy doing it here.
And we enjoy. Okay, the next one, next color.
I can see this boy doing it here.
Next color. I'll give you the improvisations over here. And the improvisations, Priyanki ma'am, what we could do over here is?
We can do a lot of improvisations over here. So for toddlers, I'm keeping it simple.
Okay.
For the PK, we can introduce either number or you know the sound. So at Purna.
Yes, yes.
And for the others, for K1 and all the at families. And maybe the K2 can go for the blends here.
Yeah, once we can play with numbers, the other day it can be literacy,
yes,
alphabets.
Absolutely. And for the elder ones, the same game can be made into noun adjectives. So anything.
Yes.
And if you have a sibling, this game is meant for two. There is one person who will be required to do this activity and the other one who will be doing. So the doer and the doer both are there. So if you have two kids and you don't know what to do and you want some time for yourself, it's an apt activity. A very good one.
So now let's start the game.
Yes. Okay.
Two white and two colored. Okay.
Okay. I'm muted.
Okay. I have a paper as simple as this. Any paper will do for me. But it should be like this, where you are going to make it in this manner. Can you see this? Okay. Now, my butterflies.
Now, actually, you know, this actually becomes a trunk of an elephant.
I'm not going to those because I don't have the time. But when you have the time, you can make it like a trunk of an elephant. But right now, it's an open trunk. So this, if I put it this way, it becomes like a trunk. But I'm going this way now. Okay. My butterflies are going to be in here. Yes. Please come. I'm sure your trainers at home, these trainers, all of you, chai to sabhi peete honge, ma'am. So, chai to sabhi peete honge, nahi?
Yes, ma'am.
So all of them will have strainers.
Yes.
I have different size of strainers here. One.
Juice strainer.
Two. And the vegetable washing strainer.
Yes.
Okay. So, if it's a toddler, they can go with a bigger one. Because, you know, running around is a little bit more for them. The next phase can be this. And our parents can be doing this. Yes.
So right now we'll go with the medium one.
Okay, ma'am.
And let's see how he does this.
Okay. Okay. So transition to K2.
If we can't, we need to order.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Sure, ma'am.
Okay. So here we go. So now, as I said, you need two people, a doer and the person who's doing it. Okay. So I mean, I'm going to do this, and he's going to do this activity. So here. I'm going to blow this Priyanki map.
Yes,
and these butterflies, oh my god, are going to be out in my garden, which is inside my house itself. And here I have a very naughty person who's going to catch me with the net.
Okay. Your butterflies.
My butterflies. I'm going to set them over here.
Okay.
Okay.
A little closer so that I can come closer. Okay. Yeah, fine.
Okay, here I go.
Not a single one. It's not that easy. It's not
so
that easy.
I successfully let go all the butterflies into the nature.
Not a single one. Not that easy.
So that was
so, ma'am. You included that cutting scissor activity. Then you included coloring.
Yes.
So you included even butterflies. Like butterflies can fly. You can give it different shapes, colors, so many things. And then also the fun part.
And the coordination really amazing, also.
And of course, the literacy, numeracy in it, and their coordination, visual, and most important, the nature, conserving nature, letting the butterflies out. And if you're not able to catch it, then you're a good person. You're literally.
Okay, so I hope the toddlers and the pre-Ks will be happy. We have looked at this and come out with something innovative. So this can be done anywhere, everywhere, very, very easy to do. Everything available at home. No looking for butterflies, nets, anything like that. And those who have a garden at home can try to start in nature. That extra effect. Okay. I think we had a lot of fun. Yes.
Yes. I can see this child doing something here.
Okay. Catching the butterfly.
Yes. And I can see this child doing something here.
Great.
Yes.
We're all enjoying. That's the power of game, ma'am.
And this one is figuring out coloring. Till now, he's coloring.
He can catch the butterflies later. Okay. Priyanki, ma'am.
Ma'am, I want numeracy now.
Then why don't you come up with something?
Coordination?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Yes?
Okay, let's see.
Okay.
We can go ahead with that.
Okay. So let's see Priyanki ma'am in action now. I think I've done enough action. I need a break. I'll be back with something up my sleeves. I'm going to look for it now while Priyanki ma'am takes over.
So Ishayu will help us with the camera. Okay. Ishayu, he can help do the drawing.
Yeah.
Let's see the mom and son pair, how it works. Okay. So are you ready, ma'am? So we need two papers. Two sheets of paper.
Okay.
Two pencils.
You need two sheets of paper?
Yes.
Two sheets of paper?
Yes.
A pencil, paint, crayon? Anything,
ma'am.
Okay, just go get that. Yes. We require either of the parent, either the mom first and then the father.
Yes.
Okay. So whoever goes first.
Yes.
The child is coming over here.
Yes. Okay. The child has to play. So maybe they can compete. Like the child with the father and then the child with the mother.
We have it. Two papers?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's go with the sequence of it. What do you want me to do?
So now Ishayu will be here.
Okay, Ishayu, please be here.
Okay. I'll just turn the camera. So this is the position, okay?
Right.
So
yes.
Ma'am, just put the paper on his back, the other paper, this paper. Can you just turn the chair, Ishayu? Just get up. This is the way you should sit. Now sit. So this is the way he will sit. And ma'am, can you just take your position here?
Yeah, I'm going to take a pen, right? Or I'm going to take a crayon. Give me a crayon. Okay. So I think, you know, let's go to the gross motor crayons. Okay, this is interesting.
Just place the paper here on his back. Yes, this is the way. And Ishayu, now your mom will scribble, draw or something on your back. Okay? So you have to feel and realize what she's doing. And then the same exact replica you have to do on the paper.
Oh my God. Okay? Are we ready for this?
So as you play, they will understand the game.
Okay.
Yeah.
The first one.
Yes.
Once again, ma'am, you can just overwrite and give him the feel again. He's playing it for the first time, so. Yes.
Okay.
So can you see? Yes. Okay.
She will show mine later.
Yeah. Okay.
Next.
Okay, the mom and son pair.
Okay. On the triangle. On the triangle.
Okay, I think we can now see. Now let's compare.
So this is mom's part and this is son's part. So same way you can play this with the dad and then you can compare the coordination is better with whom, which parent,
mother or father.
So this is the game all about. So are you all trying? You can
who bonds is better.
I'm sure ma'am this result you will not tell us. The mother or the father? First, the mother plays and then the father plays.
I don't know how much they have achieved, but you saw what happened right now with my son.
Can you show it? Whoever has done it?
They're doing it.
I can see it here.
So this game is fantastic because you can also give some kind of inputs, like, you know, if you have first drawn something.
We have played this in the childhood a lot, Aprupa.
Above and below, you can talk about that. You can talk right and left. You can also talk about, you know, the different aspects that we call the concept of place, wherever the position, the preposition that we call later on. And of course, the bonding that happens and the coordination aspect. The child is actually, you know, thinking what is happening there. So your thinking skills are getting enhanced over here. So a fantastic game to play and to figure out the child is closer to the mom or to the dad, understands instructions better. So that way, you know, you can figure out
who is showing you something here.
Who is this, ma'am? Put it near the camera, we can't see.
Who is the child? What is the child's name?
Urvika?
Yeah, Urvika.
Okay. So the next game, Kanta, I think, you know, your husband needs to play because that's when we will figure out the bonding is where, mom or the dad. Okay, that was awesome. That is really nice.
He's also doing it. Jai is doing it. Jai.
Child name is Harvant, ma'am.
Okay. Harvant.
Yeah. Okay. There are some more games which can be looked at and done at home. It's called the Hello Sunshine game, which is more to do with literacy building activity, where you can make small cutouts from the paper and you can draw cute suns with different emotions on it. So the card might just face this way. And you can draw the sun here with different kinds of emotions on it, happy, sad, whatever. And the child, it's a very beautiful game, actually. So the child comes and picks up that card. And the card, when it comes this way, shows you the area in your house or maybe an object which is only available in that area. Maybe, you know, there is a particular type of a clock which is kept in your living room. So the child then needs to figure out where is that object in my house, then figure out that place in the house. And then there is an object given to the child, which the child needs to hide. A mother or a father can engage themselves in looking for that object. Then the child plays the same thing. The mother draws the card, looks for the place and then hides, and the child looks for the object. So it's a new version of hide and seek, rather than, you know, the child going and hiding somewhere and getting hurt or, you know, some kind of unwanted disasters happening. This is a beautiful way to depict the hide and seek. It's called the Hello Sunshine Hider. So that's a name we have coined.
Yes.
Please don't look up for somewhere. The name is coined by us. It's Hello Sunshine Hider. So, because it looks into happiness giving activity. You can try this game also with your little ones if you want to expel some energy out, and they can play this forever and ever for time and, you know, as much time you can give them. Okay, I think we looked enough at the
just now games. Usha ma'am mentioned that she played those games
in the childhood. Yes, ma'am, there are plenty. Yes. We have played in the childhood, and then our grandparents or, you know, their grandparents also, we would have done so many such things. But I think, ma'am, we have forgotten all of this, and we are losing touch because nobody connects us with those interesting games. We don't talk about them. We don't live them in our school. We are more bothered about those fancy things of swimming, basketball, skating, all those things, you know, where we want them to get trained on these things. But has anybody revisited those games which were existing in the past, how fruitful they were, how much of power they had? And that's why we coined today's session as Power of Game. It is fantastic if you look into those games which were played by our dada dadis, nana nanis, and the kind of things that they have, you know, come up with learning from those games. Whether it is your Chanakya ma'am, who was a super strategist, or, you know, any other ministers in the king's palace, they all used to play, including Mahabharata, ma'am, where he used to play that game and they all lost. These are games of strategy, games of critical thinking, games of, you know, sharpening your skills, logical reasoning, patience, concentration, all of them put together, the games were devised. You need not have to
outside,
but sitting them, you could achieve a lot. The typical board games, but strategized to meet your needs and connect with your mind and give power, empower them to do the best. So now we are going to the second phase of our Power of Game, calling it playing with the past.
So now we
play with our past, and let's see what we have in play with the past. Okay, Priyanki ma'am.
Sounds very exciting. Isn't it, all of you children?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, my God.
So I hope they can see the picture, right? So we are very familiar to this picture, snake and ladders, ma'am. But since we are playing with the past, so please explain how we are playing with the past with this snake and ladders. And it's kind of circular, ma'am. I'm just like, yes. Yes.
Okay. This is this was something that was done way ahead of, in the past, where that time there was no board games and this. It was done on a cloth. And I think we can do all of this at home or, you know, as a part of the art and craft activity, coordinated with numeracy as well as your other skills. It is a simple game of snakes and ladders, as all of us can see. But have you seen how it is done? It is not vertically done. It is circular. And therefore, when anything is in circle, the concentration required is much more. Try it. Because it's like this. So it's not going this way. It's going this way. So your concentration level is much, much more. Second, it looks at the ancient art. Look at the drawing around it. There is Varli art. There are those arts which were done at that point in time. You can integrate that also and come up with these games at home. They are not difficult to make it. Absolutely not. And you can put those snakes. But here, the way it ends is right in the center. So when you reach the center, you have won the game. It goes in circle, going up, going down. And finally, when you reach the center, that's the end of the game. To make things easier down the line, we made it very simple for us, and we made it into a snake and ladder game where you throw the dice and you keep climbing up and it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And so easy to do it because it's like this. There is absolutely, mind is not stressed that much. You don't have to think that much, but over here you have to. You have to be engaged. If you lose your concentration, you are going to lose a lot of things. So the connection, the coordination, the strategy, all of it mattered along with a handiwork of your then art. all revived there. So maybe we can look at making something like this and connecting our children back into tradition, back into our culture, and showing how rich they were, right? The kind of things that our grandparents have lived, or even their forefathers have lived and gone. We can again recreate the same thing. So here, Priyanki ma'am, we have actually looked upon, touching upon some of our cultures that are there in terms of art, craft, as well as those games, which actually brought out a lot of things.
Yes.
Because today's young generation absolutely have lost connect with all of that.
Absolutely.
So we always look in one of our workshops, what is the message that we can get across to the generation, you know, our future generation. And today's was, you know, about the culture, the rich culture that India invests, always invested in, and connecting them to that, although we are marching towards the future. There is no harm taking that and putting it into your future and blending it together and creating something wonderful. So the next game.
Yes, so this is our next game. This is also an ancient game, if you can see. This is the layout of this game, so which is a kind of tile presentation. So you can see square in squares. So there are 1, 2, 3, and 4 squares. And it's called the Nine Men Morris or Navakankari. Navakankari. Nava means nine, right, ma'am?
And Kankari means seven.
Yes.
So ancient times, obviously, you had those stones and all to play with. Here you can also devise it with your maida, making balls out of it. These can be done with some sticks, those coconut jhaadus. With that you can make it. Or even
awesome.
Pardon?
This looks awesome, I said.
Yes. Ma'am, it's a beautiful game of strategy and, you know, thinking. So if you have the time to read up the game and play it with your children, it is very, very good for us also as adults, because it gives you the leverage of thinking beyond your usual. So we normally play chess and, you know, things like that and think, oh, my brains are getting sharpened. But do think about these games. They are beautiful. Name of the game is Navakankari. Navakankari. Now look at those shape, box in a box in a box in a box. I mean, nobody went to buy board games at that point in time. They all made it at home. And it achieved much, much more than what we achieved today. Okay, now come to the next one. And this, I think a lot of people will be knowing, because we have done this game with our children in TBS and TGS. We both, ma'am, as a part of our numeracy program for pre-primary.
Yes. So, ma'am, are you talking about this?
No, ma'am. The next game.
Okay. So, ma'am, like, this board will not be available with everyone. So maybe they can use that ice trays or maybe the egg plate which we get.
Even bowls, ma'am.
Yeah. And for the last,
we can just use the bowls.
Place it in this manner. This is a closer look. Just take a closer look. 8 of those. Not 8, 10 of those. And then 2 horizontal bars at the side for each player. So they have well-developed strategy for this game, but we can make it our own version and make it easier for the kids to play. Maybe we can just label each hole to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so as we can just let the child take the colored tiles and just let them drop it on the odd holes or on the even holes, or and whichever means, they can just put it on the horizontal bar. Then the one who finishes
one second up with
all the colored tiles will win the game. So we can just make our own rules. We can just set our own regulations and form a game. But the basic idea was taken from this game. The game name is Manipala.
Manipala.
Priyanki, Aprupa. Excuse me. Priyanki, Aprupa.
Okay, it's called the M-A-N-C-A-L-A, Mankala. And in different parts of India, it's called different.
Aprupa, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, there's a person, there are 2-3 people saying they can't see the presentation. What Priyanka?
There is nothing to present here. They couldn't even see the picture.
Okay, once again.
Yes.
Can you just see now?
Can you all see it now?
No, ma'am. No.
Can you, ma'am, it will be put up.
Not clear. They're saying not clear.
Okay, you can just type in by the name Mancala. M-A-N-C-A-L-A.
Yes.
You can just type in by that name. So you will find one in the web.
You will find plenty.
Yeah.
Because everybody has gone back and tried to do their version. But what we did in our school was we integrated with numeracy, as Priyanki ma'am was rightly telling, for our K-1 children, where we were teaching them, you know, the sorting, which could be of different colored beads. And the beads can be made out of maida. Once again, you don't have to look for anything else over here. You can align four bowls, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four bowls are also enough, or even 6 bowls are enough. And some kind of a, you know, plate on two sides to keep those different kinds of colored balls. And then with a pair of tongs, you can do it. Suppose I say, you know, put in the odd number, you can put it in the odd number, odd numbers. So maybe 3 will go in, 5 will go in. Similarly, skip counting can be done with this. Or even for the pre-K children, it could be the sequencing of number 1, 2, 3, 4. And they keep putting along with, it's actually a ancient version of dominoes, ma'am, which we can do over here with Mancala. Yes, M-A-N-C-A-L-A. That's right. Huh? She's written it over there. As I said, in different parts of India, it has been called by different names. It's pretty ancient. And the actual idea or the theme behind the game is completely different. We have improvised it. Please read it up and you will see how much more it actually accomplishes for an adult. Okay, these are all games that can be played by you, me, any one of us. So that's the kind of strategy it actually goes up to. It's wonderful, ma'am. So I request all the parents to read for their own benefit also, because that will build their concentration and their skill enhancement also, not only the children. We always look at the broader picture over here, because tomorrow you might say that, what about us? So for them also. Okay. Now, this is something very interesting. I want all of them to try this. Tag our page, ma'am, and then send their videos. I want them to do this, ma'am. It's beautiful and anybody and everybody can do this.
So do that, what she said to you. You know what?
The one I'm going to do now, ma'am. The one I'm going to do now, it's called the...
She said that you tag... You on the Facebook and tag yourself.
Yes, I call it as a star planner, star gazer, star glancer, anything I call it. You can give your own name and then put the tag in. Very easy to do it at home.
Yes.
There are two versions of it. I hope the picture, you are able to see the picture.
Can you all see the picture?
One version.
Okay. Yes, it is.
This is the other. This is another.
Okay.
So I hope everybody knows what a constellation is. Constellation, if anybody can define what is constellation, can you just unmute and speak up? So this is constellation in a jar.
If anybody would like to define constellation for us. Even a parent can answer.
Yeah, sure. Ma'am.
Different galaxies arranged.
Okay. So Isha, would you define constellation for us?
From my definition, I think constellation is a group of stars.
Okay. So now those groups are forming
a pattern.
Okay. Yes. So pattern, not only group of stars, the definition of constellation calls for a pattern. So take an aluminium foil, just prick some holes to depict any constellation, maybe the Saptarshi, the Great Bear constellation, and then put it inside a mason jar. And you can just put in some lights, fairy lights inside the jar and take it to a dark room. Yeah, take it to a dark room so that it glows and gives you the feel of a space inside the jar.
with the constellation.
Yes, and this is the simpler version of it. Just take a dough of maida or atta, and there you just need to prick some holes with a toothpick. And with the toothpick, just form the pattern of the star or the constellation, and then let the shadow be cast on the wall so that you can see the constellation forming a shadowed pattern on the wall. So there are two versions of it. Please try this and do tag us on our Facebook page. So I'm just trying to show you once again. This is constellation in a jar done with aluminium foil and fairy lights inside. And this is done, this is actually done in a wooden like block, but you can use maida, dough of maida or atta, wheat flour dough or refined flour dough, and then prick holes with a toothpick to cast the shadow on the wall.
Isn't that awesome?
It's really good.
So that's called shadow play. You are teaching them shadow also through this method of a game, constellation, and exploration of your own knowledge. I mean, you can create your own constellation also and name them and send it to us. We don't mind it. We can, the puri, ma'am, the thing with which we actually make the puris, they have small holes in it. So you can actually, you know, form a pattern there by closing the holes and just creating that pattern and putting the light through and creating the shadow. That also works pretty well with this. So try and explore. And these are some thoughts that came to us where we could, we thought, you know, let's share it and empower you with the power of game. So ready for another game. And this game is pretty interesting. I want everybody on the floor, on the table. No, ma'am. First, we will do the lung power because we need to test, you know, how fit they are. So we're going to do this with that. So again, improvised to our academics. Curriculum best defined. Out of the box.
Okay.
Yes.
Come on, all of them.
So these are the things we require.
Any bowl. This is an artistic bowl. You don't need an artistic bowl, but you can make one. Papers cut to this size. Yes.
Now, when you cut the papers
to this size, I want you all to write G, A. So basically games. G-A-M-E-S in each paper, G-A-M, and then F-U-N. So these are the letters that should go. G-A-M-E-S. F-U-N. Get them ready. If you have a straw, whichever is good. Otherwise, you can create a straw by rolling a sheet of paper. So don't tell me, you know, ma'am, you did not tell me I required all these things. You can just roll a paper also. Okay. Are we ready, ma'am?
You have, yes, ma'am.
Again, you know.
Yes.
Come with the picture.
Yeah.
We have the bowl kept here. I am decreasing the degree of difficulty here, ma'am. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
But you can increase it as much as you can, depending upon your lung power here. And these papers are going to be randomly thrown up. These can be colorful also, ma'am, just to add some spice, as I said, into this game.
Yes,
you can put some music in between. And most important, Priyanki ma'am, over here, is you have to give set a time.
Yes. Time limit should be set.
Time management.
Yeah, time management.
Okay, here we go. Ready? Steady, go.
Blow in. Yes.
Yes. Next one.
Good going, Isha. You. But see to it, you are picking those chips with proper alphabet so that you are able to make a word.
Yes. So the twist is, you have to pick up only alphabets with which you can form words.
Yes.
It's not about the question of picking all the chits. Now, if you can pick all the chits in that given time, nothing like it.
Yes. So, ma'am, are you checking the time?
I think he has got
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay. Now, form a word.
Good job.
Make a word
from those.
No, not games and fun. Games and fun are not included in this. Something else. Arrange them. Not all the letters.
You can make several words.
No.
Okay.
Let's see. Okay. Why are you asking me?
Isha, you rhyming word with game is name. Yes. So form.
F-A-M-E.
Okay. Mega. Very good. Sun and Mega. Wow.
Okay. What is he doing?
He's trying to create more words with it. He's trying to place it in such a way so that he comes up with more words.
Okay. He's made a gas.
So, ma'am, again, the time countdown begins. 5.
Make fast. Four.
It's all right.
Three.
It's all right. Three. Left one.
Fast.
2. And the last count.
First one was better.
Time up, actually. Yes. But you were assisting us, so maybe.
Yes.
So, okay. Same as words.
And,
so he had sun, and mega, and then?
Yes. No, we could have done a...
Gash.
And fame.
Gas, fame, name, sun, mega. Yeah. So he came up with all those words. Thank you so much, Isha.
Very
so
nice.
I hope they are all enjoying and trying at the same time.
Yes. So you can enhance your vocabulary and in your given period of time. So again, integration of a game, your breathe in, breathe out, and getting over there and forming some quick words here and there. And maybe you can make it even more. You can make some sentences out of it. You can do whatever you want to do with it.
Just think.
Just explore. Coin juggler, ma'am, please, ma'am. Ma'am, we are left with 2 minutes only, ma'am, please.
Okay, she insists I do this coin juggling activity. Yes?
No, ma'am. Our version, ma'am.
Our version. Okay. So here is the twist to this coin juggling. I'm sure, Usha, ma'am,
everybody has got coins at home.
Coins.
I think all of you got coins, so why don't you get it?
Any coins. I'm not looking at, any shape, any size, any
coins.
Denomination. Just go grab few of them and come.
Yeah.
Piggy banks. I hope the concept of piggy bank still exists. Concept of piggy bank.
It looks into a temple.
Okay. So see this? We have some coins here. And I'm going to use the same bowl, ma'am.
Okay.
No, I'll take the bigger one, ma'am, because this requires a
So I'll turn the camera and show them the steps.
Okay, shall you need a stool out from there or anything? Because I have to do this activity now. I've never done this before. Although we have just come up with this.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to keep a chair here and the coin here. And I'm going to set my degree of difficulty very less.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, but and for your, you should increase it. If you are achieving the level 1, it should go to level 2. Now.
Level 2 in terms of distance, right?
Yes.
This initial point remains the same.
Now with these points, what am I going to do? I don't know what are the denominations here, ma'am.
Okay.
I don't know. See, there are different sizes of the coins also over here and different colors. Yes?
Yes.
The rule of the game over here is I have to use only this much. Only this much. From my nose, eyes to my forehead. No lips. No putting the coin in your mouth. Okay, that's the rule. You put there, you're out in the first place. You will only use this much. And you want to transfer as many coins you can into that bowl.
Ma'am, please show me.
Within about 10 seconds or whatever timer you set to yourself.
So
I don't know how good I am at it. So I'm going to try. So
yes,
here I go. I'm going to go very slow here. So here I've closed my eyes. I don't even know where the bowl is. I'll try to do this. And now I can't do anything. I have to go to the goal and
okay. Good job. And good job, ma'am. Yes.
And then, you know, some more. Okay. Now, this time I'm going to touch, put it on below my eyes and see if it works, ma'am, on my forehead. Okay. And again, I go. I need to know where my bowl is. So, I can't. Okay. After I've seen where the bowl is.
Okay. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
And see what happens here.
3, 2, and 1.
Okay. So, when your, you know, the time thing comes into play, look at the coordination going haywire. Yes? Now, what are you going to do?
Ma'am, it's not so simple, ma'am. What will you do with this coin?
Oh,
play without any use. Of course not.
Yes.
Stick some academics in every day, ma'am, for the fun part with play. So, these are the coins. Different
here. So, Priyanki ma'am, over here, I have actually built one more thing. And that is, there are coins from different countries also.
Oh, ma'am.
So, here I can do the sorting by countries. I can see which coin belongs to which country. I can sort it with the size. I can also sort it by numbers. And for the elders, I can count and figure out, do an addition. And do the money concept as to how much money I collected in that much point of time. Second level, a person who achieves that level goes, increases the distance, decreases the time, and does the whole thing. So that's what this game was all about. So juggling the coin, but
with a twist in the story as usual, ma'am.
Yes.
So
and also, ma'am, counting, like how many coins you collected. So you can just do the addition part. Absolutely. And the subtraction part which fell down. So addition, subtraction, all yes. Coming into picture.
How much did you get into your basket over there? So that many you lost.
So maybe you would have had that much, but since it spilled out, you lost on those. So I hope all of you loved it.
Yes, it was so beautiful and
so that brings us to the end of this session.
I think the Harvant is doing something. Let's see.
Okay, he's holding it and going, ma'am.
He's holding
it. Difficulty over there.
And then he's trying to put this. Very good, Harvant. Let's clap. Come on, come on. Good job.
Very good. Awesome.
Yes. Good job.
Excellent. Superb. Yes. Okay. And before we end every session, there is something that I always have for y'all where I tell, you know, like rice, there was a full form of it. Similarly, there is a full form for game also, which we have coined. Okay. So Priyanki ma'am, I'm going to look here and talk.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Yes. Because
And giving everyone an equal opportunity. So we are teaching them that each one has to wait for their turn and equally everybody gets that opportunity to explore that same thing. Games teach you that. It allows the body and the mind to coordinate, enhances your critical thinking skills as well as a logical reasoning skill. That's the A. So the A actually has gone there, but that's the A. Allowing the body and the mind to coordinate with each other. You did see that your body and your mind has to be coordinated. Your thinking and what your body is doing has to be well coordinated to achieve your goal.
M. Management of time and people.
Both.
It's not only about time management, but if you're playing in a team, it's about your people management and your skills, how you deal with them in a scenario, whether it's your peers, your friends, or even in your family, the people over there. Then we come to E, you require a lot of energy. I think I've shown enough today, with my activity, flexibility activity, and ending with my coin juggling activity. That's like a lot of energy today. So energy and enthusiasm, it gets all out of you. So younger the children, expel those energy out and create that sense of enthusiasm. Add music, add some kind of more spice into it and make it happening.
And the last one, of course, ma'am, since it's games that we play, we inculcate the spirit of sportsmanship in them. That, you know, it's okay to lose. It is fine. It is about participating and, you know, putting in your best over there. Failure, being a winner or a loser, hardly matters. And therefore, for all of us, they are the ones who have gone ahead and shown that courage that they themselves, you know, that themselves makes them the winner. So that was the power of game. The game empowers you with. So all of y'all, for the next few days, explore this power of game. Here I give it to you to explore and get back to us.
Very nice. Anybody has got any questions for them? You can always tell Aprupa, and she's here to take the questions. And if you don't have the question, then we are trying to bring this whole session to an end. So do you have any questions for Aprupa and Priyanki Debroy? I think Priyanki and Aprupa, we really enjoyed it. Did you all enjoy it, children? Just say yes by unmuting your video.
Please do that.
Yes. So somebody saying I will buy Glucon-D.
Yes. You need not go to buy again Glucon-D, Mr. Jay. You can eat Glucon-D at home once again. Simple resources.
Because we believe.
Simple resources. Yes. Yes.
And they're saying thank you very much. Very educative. We'll explore and upload the video tagging you. That's what somebody says. Yeah. So far, I was not using it, so they will use it now.
Ma'am, sure. can you share the pictures of those board games you have? You were showing it today, especially the circular one.
Oh, the triangle snake one. Ladder. Okay, wait.
Yeah,
we'll do that.
Pictures. You can share it to the group.
Absolutely. I think it would have been recorded, ma'am, on Facebook.
Recorded on the Facebook. Yes.
You can have a look.
Go to the TGSB Facebook. It's live. And go there and you can have a look at it because it's saved there.
Looking easiest way, actually. Okay, no problem.
Thank you, Manu Chakravarti, to have coordinated. I think all of you had such a lovely session. So what did we actually gain out of the entire thing? So in a nutshell, it is, she also taught us what is game means, G-A-M-E, and having fun with games and the power of the game. It was a beautiful concept, Aprupa. And not only that, she also connected to our culture. And she also said that games is connected to our past. And we have played a lot of these games in our childhood. That's what I could see, especially the one which they were trying to write at the back of a person and trying to guess. That yes. I have played a lot in my childhood. So I think we can all connect to these games when we play. And many more games we can come up with when we're playing with our children. And of course, they connected that also to literacy, numeracy, as well as the everyday science. That's what they did. So I think it was a beautiful STEAM workshop and I really enjoyed it, Aprupa.
Thank you so much.
For them, Aprupa?
No, that's about it. Please, you know, go ahead, like our page and please upload the activity that we gave, making your own constellation. You can name whatever you want and put up those lovely videos and join us again for another STEAM session.
So when is this next STEAM session, Aprupa?
Ma'am, maybe Saturday if we don't have any talks happening. Yes. I really don't know if
there is a talk happening on Saturday on 13th. We have Mrs. Sharjan Samuel coming saying fat or fit, or can you be fat and still be fit? So there's a workshop happening on 13th.
No, I'm going to let them attend
that. We have a workshop. Yes. And 14th, we have got a workshop from Kathalia. And that's an art of storytelling. So that is done by the owner of Kathalia, Gita Ramanujam. Don't miss that on 14th as well as 13th. Yes. They both are very important. And Aprupa's workshop will be on the coming Tuesday. So that's what she needs, that kind of a gap to come up with such an exciting and a very, very roaring this thing, you know, something upper sleeve STEAM workshop. Thank you, Priyanki Debroy, once more.
Yes.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Learned a lot from this, and I'm sure that this constellation thing is going to come up on my Facebook, and I'm sure about it that all these children are very excited and they will do something on the Facebook.
Absolutely. So, yes.
And ciao till the time we meet on the 14th, yes, for fit and fat program. It's called fat to fit, or can we be fat and still be fit? So this is the Sharjan Samuel is trying to do it, and of course art of storytelling. Don't miss art of storytelling, because storytelling is an art in itself. So thank you so much, both of you. You've been awesome. That's what it is. All
thank
right.
You.
Thank you.
Have a great evening, all of you.
Yeah, thank you, Manju Chakravarti, to have coordinated. You have got a lot to coordinate this coming week too.
So, yes.
Thank you very much. All of
you. Thank
you, ma'am. Yes.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, sweethearts.
Bye-bye.
Great children.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
The feedbacks are there. Aprupa, they're saying they really enjoyed the activities.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am.
Yes, bye-bye. Bye-bye, all of you. Thank you so much to have come. So we're trying to end it.
No.
Thank you so much. And please log on the 14th and the 15th booth.
So much.